Sally Gunnell. A moment of truth, really. Out for the whole of last season with an Achilles problem, unable to train, unable to compete. And remember what happened this year. She won the European Cup. She was third in Jena and Nuremberg. She won the 3A's championship. And then in Lausanne, when things were going well, as she went beyond 200 meters, she broke down. And it was the other Achilles this time. It wasn't adjudged to be serious. But the problem she has is, one of the problems she has is drawn in lane two, Tonya Buford-Bailey. Akinremi is drawn on the inside, Buford-Bailey in two, Riga of Germany in three, Toshina of Kazakhstan in four, Alonso of Spain in five, Stoop of Switzerland in six, Edie of Canada in seven, and then Sally Gunnels has got a very difficult outside lane, because one of the problems is the stride pattern. Buford here, we'll talk about her first, 52.62, second in the World Championships last year, very much emerged as a superb technician at the end of last season, and she must be a threat for the gold medal. But Sally will want to get the stride pattern right. She's got the stride pattern to concern her, she's got her fitness to concern her. The training has been going well, but training is not quite the same as competition. And when you have to pull out all the stops, that's when the problems occur. So, Akinremi, Buford, Riga, the German, drawn in the third lane. Torchina of Kazakhstan. Then the Spaniard, Alonso. Then Stoop, Edie, and Sally Gunnell, who's really got to run it from the outside lane. Very difficult to relax it. She's got to go for it. Well, Sally, the defending champion, being caught by Edie. It's a tentative first 100 meters. Edie of Canada up on it at the moment. Buford going well. Buford stuttered and stumbled in the inside. That was a very poor piece of technical work by the American, but she's recovered a little bit now. And Gunnell right on the outside, maintaining to 200 meters. She's okay at the moment. Edie inside her. Now, she stuttered and very badly stuttered, Sally, and the stride pattern's gone, and she's going to have an awful lot of work to do here. Riga, the German, going well in the second lane, and Sally, way down at the moment, gets her stride pattern back. Edie of Canada in second place, Buford leading at the moment, Edie in second place. Gunnell now striding through, and so is Riga. Good hurdling technique by Gunnell. Buford-Bailey wins it, Gunnell second, Riga in third, those the three qualifiers, and just a little moment there at the change down when it didn't quite work for Sally, but she's through and she doesn't seem to have a reaction yet to the problems that have troubled her. Let's just look at Gunnell then, a little smile, she'll be relieved to have got through. She always said the first round was going to be the one that would trouble her, but let's just look at the final stages. When she came off the final stages, she looked very good.
She looked superb up until 200 meters. It went a little bit wrong there, but she did very, very well just to compose herself and get back into the race. Going ahead of Rosie Edie, there to qualify in second place probably, but Gunnell safely through.
Well, let's look. It was a difficult outside lane. She had to establish the rhythm of her own race here. And certainly the approach to the first hurdle, very important. The message from Sally is that all is well. It was great to get through. My body is okay, meaning that the Achilles problem not troubling her. Certainly not happy with the stride pattern, as we shall see and confirm a little later. That's good. Remember, she was a former 100-meter hurdler, and that technique does not go. Looking for 15s down to 16s and 17s. Go, 15 strides. The stride pattern is regular. And we watch for the change down where she almost came to us. She's overstriding a bit there, then takes the hurdle. And now let's watch. I think this is where the problems start to occur. This is where you've got to change. That's it. That's the problem. Look at that.
loads of little strides. And look at the momentum that you lose when you change down. That was not what she wanted, and it'll have to go better than that. Edie on the inside put real pressure on. In a sense, that will have helped her because it will be a real test. Now, Sally at this stage starts to get the stride pattern back again, and she'll be alternating at this stage, that is to say, using alternate lead legs. Stutters a little bit into that hurdle again, but safe. This is where she has to work. She's got a good flat 400 under her belt this season. It's tentative, but adequate. And Edie, who's got a best of 54-53, six times Canadian champion, really put the pressure on her. That's better. She got better and better as the end of the race approached. But the stride pattern, not good, but she has got through that psychological barrier. Legs feel good. She feels a little more confident, we're told, and that augurs well, and perhaps she'll be able to let go a little bit in the next round.
Well, one of the advantages that Sally has over the rest, she moved up from 100-meter hurdles. She was a great 100-meter hurdle specialist, and her technique over the top of the hurdles is so competent, so good, so smooth. So that's something she doesn't have to worry about. Something that Sandra Farmer-Patrick was never very good at. So if she can get the stride pattern right, who knows?
Well, let's bring you up to date with that result then. Beaufort Bailey, 55.23. This is the second heat result. Sally Gunnell, 55.29. Riga, 55.33. They're the three qualifiers. Can't tell too much from that time, but I believe that Sally Gunnell will have gained a lot of confidence from that. And I think that time will come down considerably in the next round.